for a sleeper cab, right?
Yeah, potentially in the future. When there's enough charging to make that make sense. Right now it's hard to find a way to be out overnight.
But in the US also no sleeper cabs yet?
For the Tesla truck? No.
Not yet. Because you have also a lot of space in the back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, right now it's just aerodynamics and storage.
So. Good.
Yeah.
Then
I think the more point of this is to be autonomous. I think they're working more on this, so no need to sweeper cap.
If we'll work on that as well. Oh yeah, that's a good point.
If it's autonomous, nobody will go.
You have your snowboard with you.
Mm-hmm.
And do you have a Cybertruck or only this tractor?
I don't have a Cybertruck, no.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Good, have fun.
Yeah, likewise.
So it has the license to be autonomous in the USA, but in Europe, do you work on this or you are not?
I don't work on the autonomous part, but you know, it will have autopilot. It'll have the hardware for autopilot, and we'll add features just like we do in our cars.
So for the software, you have it from the car, so you don't need to start from scratch.
For the UI software? Yeah.
Yeah.
It's similar. It's a unique one for Tesla, but yeah.
So no compartments for storage.
Keep it simple.
Is it touchscreen or?
Yeah, it's a touchscreen, but that one's off because the car is off and it's locked. Yeah, but that has. That's how you control opening the hood and the doors and all that is with that screen. And then when you're driving, that shows the preview of what's around you for autopilot.
Here is the driving mode switch, RNDR.
There's a couple buttons, not that many though.
Okay, nice. And the batteries are under here.
Yep.
So we are stepping on lots of power here.
Yep.
Star roof. And what's this third small pedal? This is for the steering wheel adjustment.
Steering wheel adjustment.
So you can.
So you can do it hands-free. Yeah.
Like this. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
375.
Thank you.